The deeper you think about automobiles, the more you will appreciate the role of friction in their running mechanism. This is a detailed video on how to fix slipper clutch by replacing a conventional multi-plate clutch. Avoid skipping points in this video as a lot of minute yet important points are covered here. So let's start off by removing the drain bolt, which sits under the oil sump. Use a 17mm socket or a spanner to remove it. Let the engine oil drain, and in the meanwhile you can remove the oil filter by removing these 3 bolts using a 8mm spanner, and then you can take the cap out. Inside the oil filter chamber, you will see a cap bolt. Remove it using an Allen key or a hex socket. Don't forget to take the metal washer along with it. Next, we have to remove the clutch mounting bracket. There are different ways to remove a clutch cable, and I prefer this one, where we remove 2 bolts holding the clutch mounting bracket using an 8mm socket or a spanner. Remove the dipstick to get an easy access to that second bolt. Avoid dropping anything into that oil filling inlet, and if it ever happens, we can remove it as we will eventually open the clutch case. Now, disengaging the clutch cable is very easy. Just pull the clutch arm and slide the clutch cable out. Moving forward, we have to disconnect the oil cooler metal pipe, which is again easy, as it is just secured by one single flange bolt. Here, we are again using 8mm socket for the job. Here we have the main clutch case, which is secured by 9 bolts at this point. It's easy to miss any one of them while removing. So let me point out them, and yes, again we will need 8mm socket or a T-spanner to remove this. So I have already skipped the time consuming unbolting step here. So all the bolts are already loose. So let's pull the bolts one by one. So this is the first one. Okay, I've already missed one here. So that's the second one. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Sixth. Seventh. Eighth. And finally the ninth one. Usually the casing will be still stuck in place even after all the bolts are removed. So we have to gently tap the casing at the joints. I am using a soft nylon mallet here. No need to prove yourself as a Thor by applying giant forces here. Remind yourself that marvels won't pay even if you break or damage anything here. Once you notice the clutch case has come out loose, give a gentle to and fro wriggle to the case till it gets free. Finally the clutch case is out, and here you can see the spring and the dowel pin. I don't know about others, but every time I see an open engine, gearbox or a total clutch assembly like here, I can't stop myself from appreciating the engineering beauty in front of me. Let's start the disassembly by removing the adapter pin. You just have to pull it out. This adapter pin aids the clutch in engagement and disengagement. The small steel ball you are seeing here sits inside the adapter pin. Make sure you don't misplace these small things. If possible, use a magnetic plate. For a regular clutch replacement, you have to remove these head bolts using a 10mm spanner. For our case, we start off by removing the bearing. Next, we have to use this crown type clutch nut removal tool, which helps in removing the clutch holding nut. Here we are using an impact wrench attached to the clutch nut removal tool, which helps to remove the slotted nut with the help of an impact. So here we have the slotted nut out. Do note the metal thrust washer on the clutch shaft. Slightly pull the clutch assembly and take the washer out. Remember to note the orientation of the washer. Once the clutch assembly is out, you will find a similar thrust washer on the back of the assembly. Time to start the assembly. Slot in the thrust washer with the same orientation into the shaft. So here comes our objective, that is to fit the slipper clutch. No need to soak in the clutch plates here, as the clutch plates come pre-lubricated. Don't get scared if the slipper clutch doesn't fit at the first try. Loose the three bolts using a 10mm spanner or a socket. After loosing the bolts, align the clutch plates according to the clutch housing. With properly aligned clutch plates, the slipper clutch assembly easily slots in into the clutch housing. Give a tap to ensure the clutch has made its way in. With the slipper clutch in, tighten back all the three bolts. Again, put the second thrust washer back to its place. Next comes the clutch nut. Slot the nut onto the tool and then fix it back to its place. After loosely fitting the clutch nut, I am again using the impact wrench to ensure the clutch nut is tightened enough, as the recommended torque is close to 70 Nm. Put the same bearing back to the new slipper clutch assembly. Next comes the adapter pin with the steel ball inside. Slide it back to its place. Time for the gasket installation. I did purchase a new gasket, but as you can see with my superior dexterity, which is more often a good luck, the stock gasket is in perfect condition with no cracks or tear downs. So I'm reusing it. I have done this before with no issues, but make sure you inspect the gasket thoroughly and clean it before you fix it back. With oil all around, fixing the clutch case back can be a slippery affair. The trick here is to align the dowel pin with the adapter pin, and then the clutch case will slide back to its place like a magic trick. Fix back all the 9 bolts, securing the clutch case. Don't forget the Allen bolt, which sits inside the oil filter chamber. Put the oil filter back, and finally the oil filter cover with the 3 bolts. Bring the oil cooler pipe back to its place and bolt it with the help of a 8mm socket or a spanner. Next in line is the clutch cable. Slide it back to its engaging mechanism and then bolt the clutch mounting bracket with the 2 bolts using again the same 8mm socket. At this point you can check and adjust the clutch free play. You will find a detailed video about it in the description. Finally, don't forget to close the drain bolt, which was out of sight all this while. Use a 17mm socket or a spanner to give it a final turn. Fill in with fresh oil and make sure you check the oil level, as the required quantity can go a bit up due to all the disassembly. Finally, we are done installing the slipper clutch, and the moment of truth happened some 300 kilometers back. The motorcycle is performing great, the slipper clutch is super light, and I'm eager to share a lot about it. Let's give it some time for test, but for now all I can say is, yes, it works.